Hey Flownerds, how you all doing? Magic Flownerd here, and I'm here today to tell you all about how emotions can help you get the best outcome for your art. So, let's begin. So, let's start off with a brief. So, emotions are a key aspect of art and help with the creation process. So, if you're feeling happy or sad, doesn't matter, not all art is followed by positive energy, some followed by negative or political reasons. So focusing on a particular emotion will get you a particular outcome on art. Focusing on art can help you understand your emotions and help remove some negative emotions. It allows you to express yourself and work out problems. It also allows you to produce dopamine that helps that good neurotransmitter, releases happy chemicals, and you feel a lot better. So you understand yourself better through art. Now remember, art's not just all about painting. It can also be pottery, ceramics, it could be jewelry making. It can even just be getting a big canvas and making a whole lot of colored mess. That could be your happy chemical. Give you an example. How do I do it? Well, I literally love opening up a fresh sketchbook. Always getting a brand new sketchbook really gets me excited. So I love to use colour and shape, and I love how things compose themselves together. Sometimes I don't even have a plan, it just happens. So using colour and shape, I also like paying attention to detail as well. Focusing on a particular part really helps with my focus and just trying to push out the negative energy and foster on the positive energy, because I like the smoothness of the paint, I like the smoothness of ink, I like how things just fall into place, and I love the sense of the achievement that I've done something and that I'm very proud of it. You should check out some of my TikToks and see how I do. So you need some examples. I have a few. So go out and do some rough sketches. So sometimes staying indoors can be a little bit groggy. Why don't you just go out even to your garden and do some rough sketches? That could be the beginning of a brand new project for you. So what you could do is go into the garden, roughly sketch some trees, and then see how you can go abstract or how you can add to that detail. Next, you could be doing mark making. Now you don't have to use paint all the time. You can use ink, pen, paper, ceramic, clay marks, anything like that, and see how it just all falls together. Remember, this is your project, and keep that in mind, that it's completely up to you. Now, also, as I've just mentioned, it's not just about painting. With ceramics, I did so many abstract flowers, and I loved it. Again, that sense of achievement, release the happy chemical. And, of course, set a good environment for yourself. Somewhere like this, open, or small, whatever you prefer, it's all up to you, remember. A few examples I would have, I'd have some quiet music, some nature sounds are a good idea. Have a nice drink with you, have some good textures with you as well, so the feel of a cardigan or a soft animal or something will really help you focus and relax. And of course, don't forget, praise yourself. You're in a good positive mind and you're doing a great job. You're awesome, remember. So, got a few updates. So I'm back on my dream catchers. I've managed to finish my gouache book, which I'm going to be showing you after this. And my dream catchers are now available on Depop. I really would appreciate if you could help. Small businesses matter, remember. So Phoneheads, that's all I've got time for today. I hope you're all doing okay. I think this is a good idea, especially as a pandemic, as serious as what we've just gone through, would really help you positively. I know a lot of people are going back to school, universities and work. Just remember to give some time for yourself, whether that's art or not. You deserve it, and give yourself a pat on the back. Remember, Lottie loves you, baby, and stay safe.